there as well. All right, squad, we're gonna warm up nice and easy. I love to start my warm-ups with those shoulder width feet, okay? So you're gonna turn your toes out 5 degrees. Your heels are what measure your shoulders, and I want you to just give me a nice, easy squat. You're gonna find that I start out most of my warm-ups this way because no matter what the emphasis is for the day, the legs get in on it. It's just by virtue of this is what is suspending and holding us up, right? So just nice and easy here. Remember, whenever I do squats, if you wanna hang out at the bottom, just kind of twist your hips left and right. Make the warm-up fit what you need as well, right? So all the way down, all the way up. You see a little white fur ball behind me. That is Coach Zoe. Having trouble getting her to pull her weight around here, but actually maybe she is pulling her weight. This is what she does. Sleep basically all day. So, couple more squats here, just to kind of, again, grease that hip wheel. And then we're gonna go into some walkouts. So what I want you to do is go wide with your stance. We're going to bend our knees, actually, find the ground, walk out to a plank, push up through that plank, meaning just push through your shoulders, bend your knees, and walk back in. So once again, bend the knees, walk your hands all the way out, find the plank, bend your knees, press away from the floor. Now, I don't know about you, those of you who've joined the last couple days, how you're feeling. I've heard responses from a couple of you about some sore legs. Just so you know, I have the same. So even while I'm doing these workouts with you and trying to do it at a pace that makes sense for me to be able to articulate it to you, I'm definitely feeling this as well. So if you're feeling a little sore, that's good news. We're waking up a lot of different parts of the body. All right, come on down to your last inchworm. Bring your feet together. Bring one foot forward outside the hands. And I just want you to shift forward and backward. Do a couple forward and backwards. Then I want you to drop the back knee. Get into this more tall lunge. And then just shift your weights forward. So we're getting that big stretch in the back leg, obviously here in this front hip flexor. And then what I want you to do is just sit back and let's get into that hamstring. You don't have to linger long. Just sit back, hit that hamstring stretch for a hot second, and then lean back forward into that forward lunge. Let's do about 3 to 5 of these hamstring back into the lunge, and then we're gonna switch legs just to kind of really start to open up the leg dynamically. You'll see in my warm-ups, I don't like to do holds very long, especially for the warm-up. I would rather have a more active warm-up. Let's go ahead and come back, find your plank. Just press up through your plank, squeeze your quads. Hang on here for 10, 9, 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. Bring one foot forward, your opposite that we haven't yet gotten to, and just shift forward and backward once again. So we're just using that front foot and the back toe to move through space. Drop the back knee, come into that tall lunge, shift your weight all the way forward. This should feel really good through that back leg. And now what I want you to do is to just sit all the way back, find that stretch in your hamstring, hang on to it for a hot second, and then come forward once again. We're gonna do a handful of these, just like we did on the other side. One side may be a little more stiff or sticky, and that's okay. It should be, we're not all equally balanced, so one side is gonna be a little more flexy, one side will always be a little strong. Find that last one, squad. Shift forward, all the way back, and now come into your plank once again, bring your feet back, and I want you guys to just run in some nice, easy mountain climbers. So just nice and easy. Make sure those shoulders are stacked over the wrists, and you're just gonna drop those knees in and out. Now, bring one foot back forward like we were doing the stretch, and I want you to just give me a jump switch. So give me 10 total, where we just get our foot as far forward towards the hands as we can. Once you hit your 10, find your feet. All right, squad, core time. We have a 3-minute segment here. The time will be 15 seconds for one move, right into 15 of another. So just follow along with me. The first move, you're gonna come down to the ground, butterfly your feet, hands behind your neck, and you're just gonna do a little crunch. So start when you, Start when you can. And we're just gonna crunch. Nice and easy. We've got 15 seconds here. And then I'll show you what the transition is. You've got about another 5 seconds. 4, 3, 2, 1. Bring your knees up and give me a 90 degree crunch. So I want you to really effort to bring your elbows to your knees. So all the way back, all the way up. It's only 15 seconds. We've got 3, 2, 1. Sit up, extend one leg, and the opposite leg here is on the ground. The same arm that is the leg that is bent, you're gonna lift up, tap your shin, come back down, switch legs. So up, opposite hand tabs, and we're just straightening that leg, okay? So we've got 15 seconds starting right now. You're just gonna press through that arm, lift up with a little bit of a tricep extension, and you're gonna reach for that shin. Good, gang. We've got 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. Now you're gonna come up onto all fours, and I call this the crab break dance. So it's just a version of what we just did. You're reaching for opposite shin or toe. You also, if reaching is tough, just shift your weight and lift your hands. Okay, that may be the starting point, or just hold the crab for 3, 2, 1, and rest. Here's the last one. You're gonna come down onto your side, okay? You're gonna bring your feet forward, okay? You're bringing them forward towards your head. Don't be in a straight line. Bring them forward. We're gonna do side knee tuck ups. So you're gonna bring your knees in, and you're gonna reach for that top foot and back down. So in, out. 15 seconds has started. Good squad. Stay with me. In and out. For those who want another challenge, keep your legs straight, and you can just lift them as you fold to the side for 3, 2, 1. Go onto your back and give me bent knee V-ups. So this is the partner pair. So you notice we're doing 3 different sets, and each one resembles another. We're gonna go back to the top in 5 seconds. That's your butterfly crunch. 2, 1, butterfly your feet. Hands behind your neck, and it's just a little baby crunch. You're lifting your gaze and keeping it on the ceiling. You're just moving it forward on the ceiling. We've got another 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. Bring your knees up right into that 90 degree crunch. So maybe you're pulling a little more, lifting a little more through your back. Try to make contact. So whether that's bringing your knees a little more forward or your elbows a little more up, try to make contact with your legs for 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. Good job. Let's go back into that seated crab. So remember, one leg long, up, tab, and switch. Up, tab, and switch. If you really start to get into it, you can pick up the pace like this, leave one foot even off the ground, right? There's so many ways to modify either up or down. 5 more seconds here, and then we're gonna get onto all fours in 2, 1. Come up onto all fours, and let's do that crab break dance. This is my thoughts on if a crab could break dance, what a crab could do. Don't know if that really exists, but just my way of imagining things. For 3, for 2, where are you going, Zoe? Zoe's done with this core game. All right, side tuck ups. So we come into the side, rely on that bottom arm, and go. You can either do straight leg, or you can do bent knee, okay? You can even alternate. I'll leave it up to you. So either side and bent, or side and straighten. Stay with it for 5, for 4, for 3, for 2, for 1, and then come into your bent knee V-ups. All the way down, all the way up. Stay with it, squad. Good stuff. Stay with it. We've got 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, and 1. Good job. All right, come on up to your feet, squad. We're gonna do a version of a squat we have not done. It's called a staggered squat. So what's gonna happen is, You're gonna have your feet right underneath you, equal distance apart. Then I'm gonna start with my left leg and I'm gonna pull it back just to where the toe is in line with the heel. That's it, it's not a step back. I'm starting here, I'm pulling the toe right back, maintaining the distance of width. This is a staggered squat, it means one leg is gonna get more emphasis. So what you're gonna do is you're gonna unlock the knees, you're gonna squat down as low as you can. This leg is a kickstand. Your left leg, if it's pulled back, is just a kickstand to enable the emphasis to be more in one leg. If you've ever wanted to do a pistol or one-legged squat, this is one of the entry points for this. We're gaining strength in the one leg. We're getting it stronger. And also, because the legs aren't equal, one is always stronger. We're always leaning on one. Now switch legs, pull the other one back. Again, just so that the toe is in line with the heel, but there's distance, hip width distance, and off you go. Back into that squat. All the way down, all the way up. These are great things you can do. Yesterday we did tempo, today staggered. When you don't have load or weight, this is the way to make the muscle believe you have extra load or extra weight, which means we're getting stronger. We don't have to have the dumbbells. We just modify the versions so that we trick the body in thinking, all right, the muscle's under contraction longer and we're gonna stay with it. Give me two more squats, gang. Keep that front foot all the way down. And now what you're gonna do, we're gonna get into a low shuffle. You're gonna shuffle one way. You're gonna come down into a plank, back up and shuffle. So only going about 5 or 6 feet. We're gonna get that cardio heart rate up a little bit here. Just follow me all the way back and forward. You're hitting that plank. You can obviously step it back, step it forward, and you can also walk left and right. Back down and forward and stay low and walk it. Lots of ways we can get through this depending on where you are. Good, gang. Give me one more lateral each side. Good stuff, squad. Now you're gonna come down to your belly, okay? We're gonna reach our arms. Make sure you have room left and right, okay? Now what you're gonna do is you're gonna lift your chest and you're just gonna bring your arms up and down. Palms facing down, squad.
Can't see you, Heidi.
Uh-oh. My Zoomers.
Nobody can see you.
Nobody can see me. Here we go, Zoomers. Sorry about that, squad. There we go. So up and down. Keep your feet on the ground. Now turn your thumbs down. Same movement. You're coming right out of your shoulders. Up and down here, squad. Thumbs pointing down. And now the last one. Palms up. And we're still using that motion. Are your shoulders dying? Hopefully I'm seeing some nods. Yep. Keep going, keep the arms straight for 5, 4, 3, 2, and 1. Good, come on up to your feet, gang. Last round of the staggered squats, okay? So find that pull back. I'm starting with my left foot back, right foot forward, and you're gonna squat. So we've been here before. So now let's play with how low can you get, right? We're using the back leg to support, and we're just putting the emphasis right here. So get down as low as your mobility allows. Don't go so low that you fold. I want your eyes up, and I want your chest up, and I want you to put your mind into your front leg so that it works harder. 5 more wherever you are. Count out 5 more reps, and then we're gonna switch squad. Awesome. Okay, bring that back foot forward. Replace it with the opposite, and we're going right into it. So the back foot is on the midfoot, right? The heel's lifted on the back one, but the front foot is down. Equal grip from toes to heel, toes to heel. Do not lift up this front foot. We want it stable and creating a good foundation. 5 more, squad. Count it out for yourself. Give me a couple more if you're on my pace. Good. And now go right into your low lateral shuffle. So all the way left and right. hit that plank, and pop back up. Remember, I'm also down with this. This is actually, might be in a lot of ways harder because your muscle stays contracted. Otherwise, we are getting a little bit more repetition. Good squad. Stay with it. All the way out, all the way back in. We've got 10 more seconds. Good. Hang on. We've got 5, 4, 3, 2, and 1. Come down to your belly. Okay, we're getting into that T position. Palms facing down, squad. Lift up through the chest and bring those arms up and down. So quads, toes, all on the ground. I want support in your low back as we do this. We're keeping that back under constant contraction here. Stay with it. Now thumbs down. Thumbs down, arms are straight. Breathe nice and easy here. Squeeze your triceps. You know what those are? Those are the back of the muscles of the upper arm. If you can squeeze those, I know your arms are straight. If you can't squeeze them, I know they're bent. Now palms up. Last round here, squad. We're moving on after this. Stay with me. You have 15 more seconds. That's all this is. We're now down to 10. We're in the single digits of leftover time. 5, 4, 3, 2, and 1. Good job. Come up into a cobra if you're still on the ground. Look left, look right, and then slowly get to your feet. All right, squad. Next round, we are going to be doing 30 seconds. We're gonna do 2 moves, and we're gonna repeat those 2 moves before we move on. So here's what we're gonna do. We're gonna do a leapfrog. We're taking it back old school style. We're gonna do 2 leapfrogs and return home with a backwards bear crawl. So what it means is you're gonna come down to the ground, use your hands to bring the feet together, and then once you've hit 2, you're just gonna bear crawl back. So once again, hands and feet together, and then bear crawl back. The second move will be mountain climbers. We'll stick the plank and we'll run the feet in, and we've got 30 seconds of each, okay? 2 times. So here we go in 3, in 2, 1. Here we go. 2 leapfrogs, and then keep your hips high, bear crawl back. 2 leapfrogs, keep your hips high, and bear crawl back. 1 and 2, and then you're just pushing back with your hands. Now, what you can also do is just bear crawl forward and backward if the leap is too much. Okay, we've got another 6 seconds here. Do that version that makes sense to you. 3, 2, 1, find your plank. We're going right in. Try to go right in. This is the challenge, to try to minimize the break in between. Knees running in. If you want those obliques a little more, do the crossover. Otherwise, knees straight in. Now squad, what I'm about to ask of you is the tough part. We're gonna try to go right into the leapfrogs again without much of a transition. 3, 2, 1, and off you go. 30 seconds, find your leapfrog, or you're doing a forward and a backward bear crawl. Okay, either way, make the transition smooth and quick. Already coming up on the last 10, squad. Stay with me. You're gonna get a big break coming up as I go over the next part. Give me 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. Right into your mountain climbers. I know it's burning. Obviously, if you have to take a break, take it. Otherwise, I want you guys really trying to cruise through this. Knees in and out. Stay with me. Coming up on the last 10 here. I know it's burning. My shoulders are on fire right now. We've got 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, and 1. Good freaking job, squad. Okay, come upright, grab your air back. We're gonna do the same thing with 2 different moves. 30 seconds each. We're gonna go through it twice. The first one is for your back. You're gonna like this one because we're gonna lay all the way down, feet on the ground, back of the arm on the ground. This is a lying scap raise. You're gonna literally use the back of your arm to lift up through your shoulders and control the way back down. This is an awesome upper back strengthener when you don't have weights. So we're gonna do that for 30 seconds. And then you'll just literally lift up, place your fingertips on the floor, and we're gonna do in and out, okay? Two times through. So 8 seconds away, find yourself on your back. You won't be here long, but at least we're starting here. In three, in two, one, and press up through the shoulders. So the elbows never leave the ground. Your glutes are on the ground. Your shoes are on the ground. Your feet are on the ground. And I want you, as you press up, squeeze your fist and really put your mind into your upper back. Okay? I promise you'll get more contraction in the muscle. This is an incredible move when you don't have, for example, a lat pull down machine or dumbbells. We've got 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. Find your fingertips on the floor and right into in and out. Knees to chest as much as you can. If your back is bothering you, just give me sit-ups, okay? There's so many ways we can do this, okay? But if your back's not bothering you, this is also a way to strengthen it. We've got 7 seconds left, squad, which means we're now down to 3 by the time I finish my sentence. Good, roll back. Lying scap raises. Go right into it. Now, for those who need that next challenge, what I'm gonna do in the last 10 seconds is we're all gonna hold up, squeeze our shoulder blades together like we're holding a pen or pencil, and you're gonna hang on. In 3, 2, 1, squeeze. If you are squeezing hard enough, your hands and upper arms should be shaking. We've got 3, 2, 1, fingertips to the floor, right in. Again, if the back's bothering you, just do a version of sit-ups that alleviates any pressure for yourself. In and out. Now squat, here's where you wanna up the interval, do it. In and out. I want full range of motion. I don't wanna see these, but I want you to go in and out as fast as you can for 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. Squat, if there's one thing you are gonna get with me when this is all said and done, you are gonna have an outstanding, strong core. It is just the foundation, I believe, for everything. So you're gonna see we have designated core and it will always be woven in. Squat, guess what? We have 2 segments left. That's all this is. The first one, I think you'll love this news. There's no repeating. It's a one and done. It's 3 exercises, but you are gonna be in the move for 1 minute. But once we're done with that minute and that move, we move on. It's only 3 exercises, 3 minutes, and then we're in our 2 minute speed round. So that's all that's left, so you have the play of the day. So 1 minute each. The first one, we warmed up with it. I'm looking for speed, but I'm looking for full extension. It is the bent knee walkout. So if you do this for speed, boy oh boy, are you gonna get cardio. We're gonna do that for 1 minute. Then you're gonna come down to the ground, and for 1 minute, we're gonna do a V up into 10 bicycles. Okay, you can do bent knee as your V up or straight leg, and then 10 bicycles. That's move 2. Move 3 is a recline rhomboid squeeze. So I'm really hitting the back today. Your feet are on the ground. You're gonna lean back, start with your hands here, and pull and squeeze. This does not look like much, but you will realize when we're in it, it is a lot. Now, if your low back bothers you, come to the ground, and you can do the scap raise that we did before, okay? All right, squad. So, bent knee, inchworm walkout. This is for speed. I want you to get down, walk out, walk back as quickly as you can. We're gonna go, I'll tell you what, give you another 13 seconds. Big inhale, big exhale. It's a one and done, 3 moves, 3 minutes, and then we're into the last little push, that's it. Here we go, squat in 3, in 2, in 1, and here we go. So walk out, walk in. Stay low as you walk out and as you push back up. Stay low to the ground, hit the plank. So don't finish here if you're watching me. All the way out, stretch out, and press back in. Good, gang. Coming up on the halfway. Remember, we're not repeating it. So do what you can here. maximize it, knowing that the move is gonna change and change quickly. Okay, we're over the halfway. Coming up on that last 20. Good squad. Coming up on that last 15. We are there now. This is it. Come on, Alexa, louder. I love it when you can cue your virtual assistant, right? You're just virtual all the way around. Alexa, louder. Good squad. Okay, one V up. 10 bicycles. Here we go. Count out your bicycles. Each leg is one, right? So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. And then you can go into some version of a V up. Or place your hands down and do a sit up to give that back a little bit of a break. On your bicycles, I want full extension of the legs. Elbows trying to connect with the tops of your legs, right? Why do half a rep? That means half of your gains are only there. So go long, really ride that bicycle. 15 seconds left, squad. Stay with it. Give me the twist in the bicycle. Those are your waist tapering muscles. Those are important ones. So don't shortcut it. Squad, we've got 3, 2, 1. Everybody sit up, lean back, arms forward, squeeze. I mean, I want you imagining you're bending iron, you're breaking a shirt, you're pulling back so hard. If your back bothers you, lean up a little bit. You're still gonna feel this move. I want you literally imagining your shoulder blades are connecting back in the middle. You are breaking a pencil in half with your shoulder blades. I know it sounds funny, but literally, the more you imagine that, the bigger the contraction. Come on, squad. 20. Stay with it. Big squeeze. Gang, we have 10 seconds. Lean a little lower if your back can handle it. 5, 3, 2, and 1. Good job. All right, squad. We're finishing fast and furious. It's 2 minutes, and we're gonna switch moves every 10 seconds. So we're gonna do some high knees. We're gonna do some lateral jumps, and we're gonna do squat pulls, okay? In between those 3 moves, it is fast feet, okay? Perfect song for this. It's gonna be 10 seconds. It's gonna be all 6 of those. 3 of those moves are always fast feet. The other moves are high knees, lateral jumps, and squat pulls. We're doing it 2 rounds and your DOAing done. So squat, big inhale, big exhale. We're going in 3, in 2, in 1. Fast feet, fast feet, come on. I don't want those heels dropping ever. I want you guys pounding out as many steps as you can and high knees. Drive the knees up. Stay with me, squat. It's almost like you're active recovery right here, right? Stay with me. 3, 2, 1, and fast feet. Always back to fast feet. I'm gonna get those quads, hips firing, calves. It's almost over. 4, 3, 2, 1, lateral jumps. Left and right. Long arms. Let your arms help move you. Stay with it. 3, 2, 1. Come on. Find it. I know I got some footballers out in the crowd. John McIntyre. Basketball OGs. We're taking it back to training camp. 3, 2, 1. Squat pulls. Squat pulls. Come on, stay with me. I know this is awful. To put it lightly, 4, 3, 2, 1. Fast feet. Come on. This is it. Last round. This is all it is. 6 10-second moves. Okay? High knees. Drive them out. Last time we're here. Get those knees up. I don't want to see, you know, lackluster performance. Finish like you began. And fast feet. Fast feet. Come on. Come on. We have 4 more rounds after this. Stay with me, and lateral jumps, left and right. This is your halfway mark. We have fast feet, squat pulse, and fast feet. Ready? And fast feet. Come on, second's the last time you're here, the fast feet. Stay with me. 4, 3, 2, 1. Squat pulse. Come on, get low. How low can you get? And maintain that contraction. 3, 2, 1. Fast feet. Come on. This is it. Finish like you want to finish. 5, 4, 3, 2, and 1. Woo! Good freaking job. Nice job, squad. Gang, if you didn't know by now, we also have a push-up challenge. It is one push-up, and then the next day, you add one. This is my day 2. I'm gonna do 2 push-ups. If this is your day 1, just do 1. This is one of the greatest ways to get push-ups for my girls out there. If this is what you've always wanted to have more ease of comfort, this is a great challenge. We're just adding 1 each day. We're gonna see how far we get while we're in this current life that is now our new normal, okay? Please post your videos, tag me, send them to me on Instagram, Facebook, DM me so that we can share this collective journey with everyone. And so make sure if you want, you can be on day 2 with me and do 1 earlier and 2 later, either way. Come on down to the ground, squad. I do want to take 2 minutes and stretch you out. I know a lot of you are doing several workouts today because there's so many incredible fitness professionals offering the same service. I couldn't be more proud of my friends. Everyone is offering free abs and strength and cardio. My buddy Evan Betts and Dina, please follow them. Their class last night was a crusher. Anthony Cricelli has a whole platform of people. There's so many incredible workouts. Guard dog, someone's at the door. Reach one leg out, one leg over. Come on up and over. Little do they know her bark is worse than her bite. Maybe you guys have dogs like that. As soon as the door opens, there's definitely gonna be licking and desires and wants for pets. All right, squat, switch legs. Come all the way up and over. Squat, I'm so grateful that everybody took the time to join me for this. I'm gonna urge you guys at the end of everything to let's all practice patience during this time. Everyone's got different issues going on, different stressors they're taking in, whether it's taking care of kids that they can't leave alone, whether it is dealing with isolation and depression, which is really rampant right now. So please do yourselves and your mates a favor, reach out, leave an audio message, just get a hi emoji. It will literally go so far to help people through this time. Squad, come on over onto all fours. I want you to shift your fingers and shoulders forward, but leave your hips up, okay? This is the way we're stretching out our upper body and our arms. So really reach your tips forward. It's not a child's pose. Leave your hips high. And then if you feel for it, thread one arm underneath. Put your head on the ground. Some of you are outside, so that may not work. You guys can stay in the tall kneel. But if you're at home, switch sides. Keep your hips high. And then let's shift our hips back to a child's pose. Broaden out the width of your knees. And I want you guys to reach all the way over to your right. Get a little spinal twist, upper back twist. Come back through center. Go all the way back to the other side. And back to center once more. Come on up into all fours. Hips high. I want you to pedal those feet. Grab those hamstrings. Walk your hands back. I want you to sit, if you can, into the bottom of your squat. Elbows on the insides of your knees. Shift your weight. Squat, I'm also going to be starting a strength program. So if you have dumbbells, great, you're in. If you don't, see what you can do to order them. Although, boy, oh boy, is it getting more difficult to order dumbbells. I ordered a couple more for myself on Walmart because Amazon was pretty much out of everything. So if you can, order a pair of dumbbells. I'm obviously going to have ways that you don't need to have dumbbells, but we're going to start a strength program next week so that we can also build long, lean muscle while we are leaning out with the cardio, okay? So stay tuned for that. Push-up challenge. Do it. Send them to me. Day 1 is 1 push-up and then add from there. I love you guys. I'm so grateful. I don't take this for granted that you are with me. I'll be back tomorrow at 12 o'clock. Have a good day. And again, please be kind to each other.